So in this video, I want to talk about how to solve vector equations. So what are vector equations? Well, equations have to have a left-hand side and have a right-hand side across the equal to sign. But the left-hand side and right-hand side would be basically vector expressions instead of a scalar expression. So something like a plus b equal to c plus d. Okay? So left-hand side is a vector expression, right side is a vector expression. Now in two dimension, if you write these vectors, then this will lead to two scalar equations. If you write these vectors in three dimension, this will lead to three scalar equations, okay? And you already know that if you have two scalar equations, you can solve for two unknowns. If you have three scalar equations, you can solve for three unknowns and no more than that. So let's say we have over here, A defined as AXI hat plus AYJ hat. And B is defined as B sub x I hat plus B y j hat. And similarly, C is this, and D is D x I hat plus D y j hat. Okay? And now I'm just choosing to write two vectors on each side, but there could be only one on one side, and there could be many more. So it doesn't really matter. Okay? All this generalizes fairly well. So we already know how to add vector quantities. So this would be added together as AX plus BX I hat plus AY plus BY J hat equal to CX plus DX I hat plus CY plus DY J hat. Now, this is a vector on the other side. If these two vectors have to be same, then their scalar components also have to be same. Okay? So what is the scalar component? What are the scalar components of the vector on the left side? It's ax plus bx and ay plus by. Here it's cx plus dx and cy plus dy. So the x component on the left side is ax plus bx, and that should be equal to the x component on the right side. Okay, that should be the case. And then ay plus by, the y component should also be same. So that's basically saying you are comparing apples to apples and oranges to oranges. So X components are the oranges and Y components are the apples, or vice versa. So that's two equations for you. So if let's say you have only two unknowns, let's say CX is an unknown and CY is an unknown, then you should be able to solve for the two unknowns. So we have how many? What? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8 quantities. Out of these 8 quantities, 6 have to be known. Then you can solve for the remaining two. Okay. So let me give you a simple example. Let's say we have a hook, okay? We have a hook, and you know somebody's pulling with a force F1 in this direction, somebody's pulling with a force F2 in this direction, somebody's pulling with a force F3 in this direction. But let's say the condition given to you is that these three forces, when they are added together, would be actually equal to zero, okay? Now, we're looking for something that is not given to us over here. So let's say F1 is given to us acting at an angle 30 degrees from horizontal, F2 is also acting at 30 degree from, you know, vertical, okay? And what we know is that F1 is, let's say we don't know the magnitude of F1, okay? So magnitude is unknown. F2, we know everything. F2 is, let's say, 5 newtons, all right? And for F3, we know its direction. So it's pointing horizontally. So this is horizontal direction. So if I draw X and Y, my reference frame, then F3 is pointing along negative X direction, but we don't know what its magnitude is. So we don't know the magnitude of F1 and F3. Those are the two things we don't know. We know the direction of every force over here. Okay? So let's write each of these vectors. So what is F1? F1 is equal to F1. The direction is known. So that will be cosine 30 I hat plus sine 30 J hat. Okay? And what's F2? F2 is equal to 5 newtons. So cosine 30 J hat minus sine 30 I hat. And what's F3? F3 is equal to minus F3 I hat. We don't know what the magnitude is, but we know the direction. So let's add them together. Sigma F is equal to F1 plus F2 plus F3 equal to zero. Notice how I write it as a zero vector, because this is basically zero I hat plus zero J hat. So this is different from the number zero, it's from the scalar zero. So what is F1? F1 is F1 cosine 30 I hat plus sine 30 J hat plus F2 is 5 cosine 30 J hat minus sine 30 I hat minus F3 I hat equals to 0 I hat plus 0 j hat. So let's collect all the I hat terms. So I hat terms, this is I hat term, so that's f1 root 3 by 2. Then this is a I hat term, so that's minus 5 by 2, and then minus f3. These are all I hat terms, plus f1 sine 30 is 1 half, so f1 by 2, plus f cosine 30 is root 3 by 2, that's j hat, and those are the only j hat term, equal to 0 I hat plus 0 j hat. So that's our, you know, vector equation. We have a left hand side vector expression, we have a right side vector expression. So this should be equal to 0 by comparison, and this should also be equal to 0. So let's do that. F1 times root 3 by 2 minus 5 by 2 minus f3 equal to 0. And second equation would be f1 by 2 plus 5 root 3 by 2 equal to 0. So 2 cancels. So this gives us f1 equal to minus 5 root 3 Newton. Okay, we get that. And then we have, what else do we have? We have, okay, so we know f1 from here, so I'm going to substitute f1 here, so I'll get minus 5 root 3 times root 3 by 2 minus 5 by 2 minus f3 equal to 0. So this gives us f3 equal to minus 5 by 2, 3 plus 1, so that's what, minus 5 by 2 times 4, so that's minus 10 newtons, right? So that's the answer for you. So you should check my math. Maybe I made some mistakes somewhere, but that's the basic idea. You have to write vector equations, which can result into two scalar equations for 2D. For 3D, you'll have three scalar equations.